Hi, I'm Mike Regan with Transact's 2-Minute Warning for the week of September 9th. We appreciate all the comments we've gotten from people that looked at our 3-part series on how you can develop a great transportation budget. And if you haven't gone to transact.com and downloaded those resources, you still have some time. And we would encourage you to do that because we've got some great information from companies like FTR and our interview last week that we had with Gary Schilling on what's going on with the economy. Now, in this 2-Minute Warning, we need to talk about something that is very, very important and unfortunately is being ignored by a lot of shippers. And the topic specifically is the level of risk when you book a shipment with a carrier or a broker. Now, why do we bring this up? Well, last week, an associate brought into my office a series of reports from our Active Scout Shipper Shield program, and they were reports that dealt with the carriers that some companies are using to haul their freight. Folks, I was stunned, actually flabbergasted by what I saw. I mean, we're not just talking about CSA scores. We've covered this in other 2-Minute Warnings. Some people say you shouldn't check for CSA scores. Others say you should check for CSA scores. Well, folks, what we were talking about was something much more basic than CSA scores. Because on these reports, I saw shippers that were using carriers that did not have a valid operating authority. Think about that. They're using carriers that don't have a valid operating authority? Well, it goes without saying if they're not checking for things like a valid operating authority, they have no idea what kind of insurance coverage some of these carriers have. And we saw some things that were stunning. Now, why do you need to be concerned about insurance coverage? Because one of our customers highlighted what happened when a carrier rolled over a trailer and returned a bunch of damaged product to the customer and said, do with it what you want. We're not paying the claim. And the reason that was important was because they're out thousands and thousands of dollars, and it could have been avoided if we had done something as basic as check on insurance coverage. And we also want to take a look at the financial condition of the carriers or the brokers we're using. Now, speaking of brokers, we want to also alert you to something that came up on the Shipper Shield report. One of my associates highlighted that under the insurance thing, there was a designation saying pending for the $75,000 bond requirement that takes effect on October 1st. Now, the reason this is out there is because the FMCSA is not yet reporting on the $75,000 bond. But starting October 1st, they will, and you're going to want to take advantage of things like our Shipper Shield report to verify that you're using brokers that have the proper bond and coverage. Now, with each and every 2-Minute Warning, we're here to remind you we are on your team and we're here to help. So if you have some comments or questions about how you can reduce your risk in selecting your carriers and brokers, give us a call today. Thanks for your time.